Somehow or another, I like to have Jesus' bike.
Yeah.
I think what I'm going to say would mean a lot more. But I thank you for coming. And I think Dorothy pretty well explained everything when she made her opening remarks. And I can't be more proud to see these young actresses and young kids take this play in January. Mind you, I mean, we started January, we decide what play we're going to have, and then we have auditions, and then we have, sign-ups for roles, and then we start practicing. And we do this in 2.5 months, folks. Give them another applause. Thank you for coming, and we encourage you to join us. Fortunately now, our next one isn't going to be until Christmas, so we have a long time to practice. Really, a lot of these people, how many people are new to the acting of you? How many is the first time? Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay.
Three failed.
Okay. So folks, now you say they did a lot of work, but there are some people behind the scenes who put this all together. And I want to see Olivia Phelan, who is your co-director. Where's Olivia? You said in the program, you're 5 years old when you started acting. She's 5 years old and then started here at the Performing Arts, and now she's a co-director. You're awesome. Great supporters of the Performing Arts Ministry. Another one I like to really say, and this is a hard thing to do when you're not feeling well. I had a stroke about a month ago, and somebody asked me about shaving. I said, well, I can only shave with my right hand, so I didn't want to look half shaved, you know what I mean? So I'd like to thank one of our great co-directors. She jumped up and took this play on 2 months ago, and she did a great job. Kay Harvey, will you come on up here? Kay, I thank you for taking this on, lady that has her own disabilities showed up here and worked hard for the 3 months. And thank you, Kay. Great job. And last but not least, I just think this lady, how could we say, made the Performing Arts Ministry what it is, along with Gigi Hondo, who's in the back. And where is Dorothy Ibarra? Dorothy, come on up. Where is she? Did you disappear? Oh, there you are. So I'm going to let Kay say something, but I want to thank you all for coming. And if we have a love donation in the back, if you feel too free to give us your retirement or any other pension that you have coming, so we can continue this ministry. Thank you much, and God bless you all.
And I would like to say that this is my first time ever of directing an adult play, but I have directed children's plays. Directing an adult play is totally different from a children's play. But I do want to let you know that I love the cast behind me. They have been the most awesome cast. When I came in and I looked at the personalities of the cast that had shown up, and I read the script, I said, okay, I don't know how I'm going to fit them all together. So I said, I want you to go home, read the script, and come back and tell me who you want to be. And Dorothy said, no, Kate, it's not done that way. I went, oops, my first mistake. But God is so good, because he allowed each one of these characters to pick out the character they wanted, and this is what you saw, the finished product. So thank you guys. Great job, y'all. I want to thank Miss Dorothy for having the courage and the trust, if you will. I've not been one that's very punctual because it is kind of hard to get around in a wheelchair. But I promised her that I would do my utmost to be on time for ahead of time for every practice. I think I missed it by two. And then I did spend 3 days in the hospital, at which time she needed to come through. So Ms. Dorothy, thank you for all your help. The story behind Olivia, Miss Olivia, is 1 year I was doing a children's Christmas Eve musical with her. And she needed to be the mayor. And she wouldn't be the mayor. Can you imagine a 13-year-old not knowing how to be a mayor? No. So I worked and I worked and I worked, and her mother even brought treats and snacks because she knew I was exhausted. I think we had to have stayed in here 2 to 4 hours. Who knows? But at the end of it, she did a perfect job then, and she did a perfect job right now with the kids. I want to say a very special thank you to Glenn Light, to Mary Light. Glenn has been doing the lights for the last 18 years. Can you all imagine that? 18 years. Glenn Light. And Mary Light, you can't see her, but she's all the way up there. So if you can, stop by and say hi to them and thank them for all their years of hard work. Gigi, I really appreciate last night. She came last night. She's here again tonight. If you want to come up here, you can. And are you going to come? Gigi? There she comes. You know, she owned her own theater. So who better to ask for the pointers of last night? And she came up here and gave us lots of pointers. Thank you, thank you, thank you for helping us. And Ron, God bless you, sir. You've done such a wonderful ministry with the Performing Arts Ministry. You're the president of it. You've been in it, I know, as long as I've been in it. And I want to say it's got to be close to 18 years, if not more. How many years, Dorothy? 16 years. We've been doing this for 16 years. But thank you, Jesus, that my first experience of being a director, and I would do it again in a heartbeat. They've given me such joy watching them tonight. Give them another round of applause. Rebecca, should have seen, Perry is not the kind of guy that wants to be involved in a whipping scene of Jesus, nor carrying the cross. So the first time he came on the stage and he saw the reality, he went, "Oh, no, I'm not going to do that." And I went, "Perry, you can't look like that." And he went, "Okay, I'll get better." So Rebecca and Perry, I can't see where you're at, but they took the whole stage together. They took the whole stage together. And, you know, I just want to say, without them, who would have known that we were in an airport, right? So if I'm leaving anyone out, I apologize.
Sandy did the sound.
Sandy
did the light.
Sandy Phelan.
That the Easter Bunny will be giving out.